Good morning, guys. Welcome to Waste Not Wednesday. Every Wednesday at 10 a.m. Mountain Time, we take junk and turn it into home decor that we decorate with at our house or sell at our shop. And I'm kind of excited and a little bit nervous because we are kind of delving into an area that we have not actually done.
Jamie was dreaming up this idea last night. She's like, you think we can make it happen? I'm like, well, we either can or we can't, and they can watch us fail or really succeed and do awesome. So
it's kind of an anthropology hack-ish. I mean, it's going to be a little bit more my style, but I spent, an hour and a half scrolling through Pinterest, trying to find new ideas for junk. And anthropology actually has these tapestry pieces with big florals and fun artwork on them, and they sell anywhere from a small one for $50 to a big one for a couple hundred dollars. And so we are going to take old drop cloth that already has paint on it, some extra boards that Zeb cut down.
So this is just a 2x4 that I ripped down to the width we need. It was 36 inches. I cut it down to 34 because we're going to try to use an IOD transfer, and that's the size we needed. We're going to stain these though. So this was leftover wood, and I just ripped it down to 3/8 of an inch. It's just a 2x4, 3/8 of an inch thick.
But you can find similar size wood at the hardware store and have them cut it to length. You don't have to rip it down. Zeb just ripped down 2x4s because we have a bunch left over at the farmhouse. So we try to not waste any of that wood. It's all in a box waiting for projects. Anyways, so what we're going to do, I'll give you kind of a heads up, is we are going to cut this drop cloth to size. We actually already have one drying in the basement because we know it's going to be a few steps. We're going to be painting the drop cloth. Then we're going to seal it with liquid patina. And we chose liquid patina because it's a little bit thicker than Big Top. And then we're going to apply the transfer on top of that. So that one's already drying downstairs. This one we're going to attempt to stamp on, so we don't actually need to seal it. The ink can go right on top of the paint.
Yeah.
So Zeb's gonna show you how he cuts it down to size, and I'm gonna check out comments.
All right, we also you wanna mix up some of my secret inking stain.
Right now I'm mixing up.
That's about to not be a secret.
I'm mixing up a base color.
Okay.
In the spirit of Waste Not Wednesday, I have crinoline and white swan. I had a little bit left over from our video we did the other day with the lemon fabric, but I needed some more, and so I've dumped just an odd mix of crinoline and white swan containers from our paint area. We actually have a bunch of partially open paint.
A bunch is an
and
understatement.
And so we are going to be...
It's like a whole display in and to itself.
I know. You're going to see us do a lot of paint mixing because I don't want to waste any of it, but a lot of it's just not enough for a whole project. So this is crinoline and white swan that I'm mixing up, and then I will stain those. So Zeb, and you guys can see this is totally a used drop cloth. This looks to be the ones that I buy at Walmart.
They're
not heavy duty.
I think these are our Old Harbor. This one is an Old Harbor Freight one. And I don't want to throw Harbor Freight under the bus, but this drop cloth does not keep things from going through it very well, which is why it's not, usually we let them get a lot more crusty than this, but this one bleeds through under whatever is underneath it. So we're just going to use this one.
Yeah, we got drop cloths for days around here. Now, Laura wants to know what these are called. She asked if it's one of those hanging, what did she call it? The hanging chart looking thing?
Yes.
Kind of. Anthropology calls them tapestries. And I actually did see, I don't know if you guys saw our video of Brambles and Blossoms, but Brambles and Blossoms got a bunch of similar looking tapestries in it. I've been obsessed with them and I don't know where to source them. And generally when I can't find a source for something, then I try to make it myself. So that's where we're at today. And we thought it'd be fun to show you one that we do with stamps and one that we do with a transfer. So you're gonna have to bear with us while we cut this out.
Well, I wanted to show you how I'm cutting it out here.
Having a big square really is helpful.
And I tell you, they're like $15. These drywall squares down at the hardware store are invaluable.
Lena says, I look very pretty today. Thank you. I blow dried my hair.
So I'm just going to put a light line here. I just made a couple dots, and now I'm just going to make a little line. It's oversized, so the transfer is 31. Is it 31? 24 by 33. So I've measured 35 inches wide and 26 inches on the height. Or, well, I guess height, that's whatever.
Wendy says she's gonna be using the Wander Transfer. We're actually using the Wander Transfer today. This one's actually gonna go on our other drop cloth that's drying right now because we painted that one with Hey Sailor, which is darker. And we thought that this would really show up well on that. And some of the tapestries that I saw at Anthropology were kind of moody and dark, so I thought that might be fun. What drop cloth would you recommend that won't leak? So we like the poly-backed, is that what it's called, poly-backed?
Yeah.
Poly-backed drop cloths, we pick them up at Home Depot. They have a plastic underneath them, and it keeps one, especially when you're doing like a blended paint finish or anything with a squirt bottle, it really keeps it from soaking through. Another option is you can just take a traditional drop cloth and throw a tarp underneath it. That will also work.
All right, got that marked out. Are the scissors over
Crescent Moon Cottage says, I'm sick of fighting my packaging tape. I'm ordering a dispenser gun. That shipping video in the membership group was amazing. Yeah, the right gun can make all the difference. We actually just barely bought a brand new gun. Like, we've had the same gun for probably 2 years, and it has shipped out thousands of packages, so it was time to get a new tape gun for our shipping room. Susan says, you're putting a transfer onto drop cloth.
We're gonna try.
We're gonna try. This drop cloth we're actually gonna be stamping on. The other drop cloth is drying down in the basement in front of the fan. So as soon as Zeb's done cutting this out, I'm gonna get started painting it, and then he'll go see. Do you think that other drop cloth is dry?
I'll go check on it while you paint this, and then I'll come back and do the boards so that they're not like brand new stark pine.
The thing about the drop cloths is they really do soak that paint up.
So this drop cloth was like probably $8, and we could probably do about 6 of these out of one drop cloth.
Absolutely. All right, and so I feel like it's a great way when your drop cloth has just seen better days to do a project with it. So
you can see it bleeds through. I guess you can't see super good, but it bleeds through.
Yeah. So this is the liquid patina. You can pick up the products we're using at jamierayvintage.com. So this liquid patina is a transfer gel and a, what's that called, decoupage medium. So it's a little bit thicker than Big Top, which is why we chose it for this project, because I wanted to stiffen up the fabric before we apply the transfer to it. Now this one we won't put, I don't think we'll put a sealer on it before we stamp, because the ink will just work great.
Okay, you're gonna paint this one up, right?
Huh?
Okay, so our table is just got an MDF top. So we don't worry about it. It was a cheap busted old table.
Well, cheap because Molly gave it to us for free.
Yeah.
She never liked it and I love it.
You guys notice that it is wobbly and it moves around a bit. It's because I didn't build it.
Well, we also have it up on legs. So we're going to hammer this down so that way it stays in place. And then I'm going to give this a quick coat of my crinoline and white swan mix.
So these are just upholstery tacks. And we did the other one without tacking it down.
It just got all over the place.
And it moved a lot. That's why. But you can do it if you don't have a place where you can tack it down like this.
Just be patient if you don't tack it down.
It just, for ease of use, since we have the ability to, we're going to do it. I need one more tack.
I have one more right now. Right here. Sorry, guys. It's a little loud. Okay.
All right, I'm going to go check on
that. Zeb's going to go to the basement. I'm going to get started on this, and I will try to paint and answer questions at the same time. Oh, I just screenshot the...
We've got a big...
What is the size you're cutting again? This is 35 by what, Zeb?
It's 35 by 26, and it'll fit the larger IOD transfers.
Oh, that's a big chunk of paint. I don't want that.
All right, so that's on there, and Jamie's just going to paint it. And you don't have to get full coverage. She's just going to go.
Well, mostly I'm just trying to give it a little bit of thickness. And the nice thing about the DIY paint for this project, the reason why I chose it, it's clay-based, you guys. It's nice and thick, so it will definitely stiffen up and add some like oomph to this plain drop cloth that's rather thin. You could probably also use the thicker drop cloths, you know, the heavy duties, but they're just a little bit more expensive. Let's see, somebody said major money, but I don't think that's what they were responding to. All right. I made a drop cloth pillow last week, Jerry says, with your stencil, it looks great. But the drop cloth wanted to fray like crazy. Stitch well. Yes, drop cloths do fray. I usually, when I am working with drop cloth for a sewing project, my sewing machine, which I don't sew very often, but my sewing machine has a triple stitch, and I always triple stitch my drop cloth because it does tend to fray. Another thing you can do if you're worried about fraying and it's on the inside where nobody's gonna see it, you can run like a bead of hot glue down it. So Maggie says she adds fabric medium to the paint and that increases the details. That would be smart if we had some on hand. I came up with this idea at like 10 o'clock last night. Sometimes it's hard with coming up with new ideas every week that aren't like something that's been done a million times. So.
Okay, I'm going to hide out over here in the corner and move your little situation.
Okay, put that over here because so I'm responding comments. To comments. Here, I can see it.
You can see it. Yep. Just don't paint it.
We don't have a Lowe's. Okay, yeah, any hardware store, like you don't have to just go to the big box hardware stores. There's lots of mom and pop hardware shops. They're going to carry drop cloths. If you live kind of out where going to
a rural area,
you could also just order them on Amazon. I have. And if you've got Prime, it's not too expensive. But if you live somewhere with a local hardware shop, definitely go in and support them. They're going to have drop cloths.
Yeah, we don't have any small hardware stores anywhere near us for ours.
Yes, the drop cloth will suck up a lot of paint.
So we use Home Depot or Lowe's. They're like across the street from each other and 5 minutes away.
It takes about, I don't know, 6 to 8 ounces of paint for a drop cloth this size, just to give you an idea. Upgraded membership to Creative Business. Welcome, Kristen. Make sure, Kristen, that you're emailing creativebusiness@jamierayvintage.com so that way Mariah can get you added into our Facebook group for business coaching and you can catch up on all the live video units that we've been doing in there. We do a new one every week.
All right, so I'm kind of over here in the corner.
Holy Batman. Okay, so Katie Scott says that in Canada, a 4x12 basic canvas drop cloth is $40 plus.
Oh, wow.
I don't know. Maybe fabric's very expensive in your country. Maybe, Katie, you should come visit me and bring an empty suitcase in just to stock up on drop cloths because that's expensive.
Okay, so what I'm doing here is I have water, a lot of water in here. It's probably about that full. And I'm just going to add some dark and decrepit, just a little bit, enough to tint the water. But I don't want it to be that brown. So I'm also going to add some old and gray. And this is one of the ways I've been mixing up stain. On our restoration finish corbels that we sell on the website at jamierayvintage.com, I use this method to make the restoration corbels. And I got over here without a stir stick. Paintbrush handle it is. So I'm just going to mix that up. Both the old and gray and the dark and decrepit are water based, so they mix well with the water. And now we've got like this nice like coffee kind of color here.
Depends on if you have coffee with cream or black coffee.
Yeah, it's got a bit of creamer in this coffee.
So who is asking? Let's see. Oh, Hannah, the business group is $29.95 a month and it comes with everything that the regular channel membership has, plus the weekly units and like throughout the week coaching, because we have a lot of questions we get on a fairly regular basis from our members. It's been fun. It's been good for us too, because it's kind of made us accountable for the things that we're teaching.
We're like, hey, do this. Oh, we should probably do it ourselves.
Okay. All right, Kayla. Okay, Ontario girls, everything is more expensive here in Canada as compared to the Michael's counterpart.
Oh, someone left the doorbell. I bet it's FedEx.
All right, I'll be right back. Sometimes they won't leave it without signing. Coming!
Run, Jamie, run. All right, okay. I'll come back around in front then so I can talk to people.
Okay, talk to people. I'm finishing that.
She'll just be a sec. All right, so you guys can see I still have a light color on this wood. When it dries, it'll be lighter than this, and I might wipe some of it back too. But it's just a good way to get a nice, and it won't go on nearly, it's not gonna have like the sealing properties that dark and decrepit usually has. Once you add that much water to it, you're still gonna need to seal this. But just a real easy way to make up a quick stain. And I don't have an exact formula. I just kind of add until it's the color I like it. Oh, got a splinter. Sounds like it's not the FedEx guy. So that drop cloth downstairs, I got a big fan on it in the spray booth. and it might not get dry. I put so much liquid patina on it to try to get a good seal over the Hay Sailor that I'm worried I may have put too much. We probably should have painted it like first thing this morning when I got here, but you know, sometimes it's hard to think that far ahead. LL, hi guys, can I paint laminate kitchen with DIY paint if I lightly sand the cabinets? Yeah, I would probably give them a 120 grit sanding. Not so much that you're like, not like 80 grit, you don't want to scratch the laminate, but 120 grit on the sandpaper would be good for most laminates, and that'll give you enough tooth that the paint will stick to it real well. Just be sure you're wiping it off real good when you go to apply the paint, so you don't have like a lot of sanding dust or anything. And then seal it really well. Our cabinets that we did, we painted them with White Swan. We sealed them with polycrylic because we weren't using a ton of the top coat when we did that. But if I had it to do over, I think I like the top coat a little bit better than polycrylic, or even like the big top from DIY. If you want a little bit shinier finish, a little more satin, that would be great on cabinets too. And ours have held up really well. It's been on there over 2 years now, and we have like one cabinet that's got some scuffs that's like the most popular cup cupboard right around where the knob is, where people like hit it with their fingernails. But
we haven't had anything peel off.
Yeah, nothing's peeled and it wipes off real easy. And I would, it'd take me 5 minutes to fix that cabinet.
Well, we have 5 kids. They're not exactly easy on anything. So I feel like if it survives the Ray test, then that's like the quality standard there.
It might have even done that to like a factory.
Oh yeah, because you're
lacquer finish.
Your cousin has lacquered cabinets, Callie's.
Yeah.
And they came straight from the factory like that, and they totally have. Theirs is worse. It's like peeling off.
Yeah.
All the, like around all.
It happens.
The edges.
The oils from your hand get on those sealers, and over time they're gonna wear it out.
It's really one of the things I suggest though is putting hardware. Because we have saved our cabinets because there is hardware, so the only wear is around that. If you don't put hardware, people grab your cabinets all over the place, and that will wear the painted finish out faster.
So something that's happened, I had blue from the previous drop cloth on my fingers, and now I've got it on my boards. There's my rag over in the corner.
I told you to wash your hands. I'm like, you're gonna get that blue everywhere. Ask me how I know. All right, is this good? I just need to do the edges right.
Yeah, and I mean, you can do it as much or as little as you want. It might just be the look.
Yeah, I'm not worried about perfection because this is gonna get tacked on to the, from the back, right? On this, how are you planning on attaching this?
Yeah, I might, from the back.
Okay.
They're a little long, so I might have to cut those tacks.
All right, I think I'm just making sure that it's nice and even and there's not any pooling of paint. I kind of just glopped it on here because wherever it's pulled up it will take longer to dry.
So I'm over here just wiping off the blue that I did. You can see up there at the top.
Okay,
from holding it.
What kind of wood are you staining? This is just pine.
It's 2x4 that I cut down.
All right. Oh, Rocio Martinez says, so true about the hardware. Yeah. You should always, if you've got painted cabinets, you should always, Deb, you want to move that camera so they can see what you're doing? Because I'm actually done for a second. I'm going to move this out of the way.
Are you going to seal that?
Huh?
Are you going to seal that, or are we just going
to? Do we need to seal it before we stamp it?
No, I don't think so. Let me go see if the other one's dry.
Okay, so I was gonna run down to the basement and grab the one that we already prepped. We did try to be a little bit organized here. Are you done with this, sweetie?
Yeah, I'm done with that.
Okay. I just want to move it out of the way because I feel like we always make a hot mess.
Yeah, by watering that down, I probably made close to 8 to 10 ounces of stain, which goes a long way.
You've got a lot of blue over here you need to wipe off.
You wipe it off if you got the clean fingers.
Well, I wouldn't say my fingers are clean, but they're not blue, they're white. Just adds patina.
Yeah, we're not gonna worry about the edges. We're going to leave it kind of raw and natural.
So if you look at Anthropologie, which was my inspiration, their edges are just kind of raw and unfinished. So that's what we're going for here. Okay, size of wood. Sorry, I was late. I think Seb says 35 by 20 something. Really, it can be whatever size you want it to be. We made it just slightly larger than the transfer. This one, we're going to be stamping on this one. And so this one could actually be whatever size you want for the design you're doing. Seb just had to make it the same size because he'd already cut the wood. Hopefully that makes sense. Can you buy DIY paint in Australia? Sue, we do ship to Australia. The shipping is a little bit expensive, but as far as I know, there are no retailers there, so there's only a few of us here in the US that ship. So if you go to jamierayvintage.com, we ship to Australia. Raw and unfinished makes me happy. I can't even talk this morning. Yeah, I like raw unfinished edges. If you guys saw where we did the shiplap wall, our curtains are raw and it's kind of.
It is still unfinished. Wet. I put way too much sealer on there. So guess what?
All right.
Heat gun time. We're gonna get this one. I know I can heat gun this fabric, kind of heat set this on here too. So it's gonna be twofold.
Could you do decals? Floral would be beautiful. Yes, we're actually gonna be doing a floral transfer on the other one. When and if it should ever dry.
It's getting there. It just needs a few more minutes. It's got some wet spots and I don't think the transfer will stick to it if it's wet at all, so.
No, it needs to be 100% dry. That is one of the biggest mistakes that people make is they try to apply the transfer before the paint is dry. If you're using DIY paint, then you need to also put a sealer on it. It gives you better adhesion and you need to make sure it's all the way dry.
All right, so while I'm doing this, do you want to kind of get your stamps out and maybe work on some layout? Are we going to do a border around here?
So I want to start off with a border.
All right, well, let's get them ready to go.
Okay. So Hello Jones says her puppy chewed up part of her curtains that were drop cloth. So she's glad we're coming up with an idea because she's going to have to cut them up.
Oh, nice.
So.
Well, and you don't necessarily, I mean, you could paint these, but if you were just going to be stamping like we do, it's just like straight up regular fabric stamping too. But I think the paint adds a lot of fun texture to it.
Well, the paint makes it stiffer.
Yeah.
So it gives you more of a canvas medium as opposed to.
It's almost like gesso.
Yeah. And like these ones, once they're washed, so your curtains probably have been like washed and softened. So adding the paint will make them a little bit thicker and more like a canvas, because they're probably soft. If you did, like, we bleached ours, and our drop cloths are a lot softer.
They got way soft.
Can you spray the drop cloth with a sprayer? Absolutely. Yeah. If you had it, like, it would have to be tacked down. But if you tacked it down, you could spray that and have it done in no time at all. Do you guys ever do freehand as opposed to stencil? Zeb has in the past.
So I do freehand, but it takes me a long time. So doing it on a video really isn't very effective. Like I get like maybe a couple things done. I did do some art last night though with some colored pencils, but I did like one flower in an hour.
Freehands for fun. I can't freehand to save my life. If you ever saw my stencil designs, you'll be like, how in the world do they take that drawing and turn it into this amazing stencil? I have like zero sketching abilities. Elva said, I'm at work. Oh, she wants to know if tile can be painted. Yes, it can be. If it's a shiny tile, you need to take some of the sheen off by sanding it, then you can paint it. And then I would suggest if it's going in like a kitchen or if it's on the floor, that you use a water-based floor sealer. It's a little bit more heavy duty.
So I just wanted to show you, it's kind of like a light brown. It's still wet, so it'll continue to get lighter. I don't know that we're gonna seal it. These are gonna hang on a wall, and I don't think they need sealed.
Somebody asked if you could use milk paint. Absolutely, I have stenciled and stamped with milk paint on drop cloth. It does work. It's not as thick, so you'd have to either mix it up thicker or do multiple layers. But milk paint actually adheres very well to fabric.
It's starting to smell like the dryer's been going in here.
Zeb, I hear you. It's like watching paint dry on a video. And Hannah says, I freehand signs and it can take almost as long to finish as furniture pieces.
Yep.
Yeah, Zeb did some freehand signage for businesses way back when we were trying to make any idea to make money.
Yeah.
And they took him quite a while, but he charged a lot too, a couple hundred dollars a sign.
Yeah, I did charge quite a bit. So if you're going to heat gun these, I would just, if you're doing this at home and you don't have to get it into an hour live video, I would just let them dry out regular. But if you're going to heat gun them, make sure you're moving that heat gun. You don't want to melt your fabric.
I'm just making sure we didn't miss any questions while I was talking.
Okay, so this is, it's still a little damp, but I think it's dry enough that it won't, we won't have transfer when we use the stamps. Like, it'll stay to the fabric.
Well, good luck with that one.
Yeah.
All right, let me see if my ink cap, I haven't.
Okay, so I'm gonna.
It's kind of dry, so I grabbed the ink.
I'm gonna bring you guys down and shake the camera all over. Oh, hey, Debbie. Yeah, this is fun. We're playing this morning.
Yeah. This is like raw creativity at its best. It's okay. Always funny when people will watch us and they'll be like, you didn't do that right. I'm like, we were just playing. Sometimes we have to refix projects after we're live because we're trying things out. So I feel like it's good for people to see like the creative process.
Do you want me to do a border?
Yeah, I was thinking border, you know?
All right, are we using several different ones or are we
do you think?
So I was thinking we could do like one of these and then do this in between them and then one of these and then do that in between them. Like make
so
this
real
be
thick
more
border?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fine. We're going to be using the Pavo stamp. So this is kind of a bohemian inspired piece. Now I voted for black background, white ink, but Zeb wanted black ink, white background. So
I think the black ink, especially when you're stamping, shows up a little better.
Alright.
On a white background.
Grabbing my
okay.
Pavo. We have not used the Pavo. So this is the, is this Bohemian? I believe so. Caitlin, if you're still on here, I don't know if you've left yet, would you take a Pavo and a Lady Shalott and a Wander out of stock? I don't know if she's still on. It might be Ivy. If Ivy's here, it's Bohemia.
Okay.
Caitlin's still here. Okay.
We gotta go darker.
Oh yeah, you need way, that's not juicy enough.
So you just loaded this ink pad, right?
Yeah, you need more ink on it. Caitlin says, crap, what was all that? I need you to take out Wander, Pavo, I have to think about it, and Lady Shalott, or how do you say, shallot?
We're gonna eat them later.
So Linda said, I immediately thought black on white, kind of a vintage look.
We might have to get black paint out.
If it's too...
It's too light. We're going to have to use paint.
I don't know if paint's going to work on that.
You know, I actually don't mind kind of the lighter. I'm just going to go this one all the way around.
Okay.
I think the lighter...
Do you want more ink?
Yeah, lots more ink.
I think you just need to make it juicier. We haven't stamped on fabric in forever. And I forgot, like, that's like the number one thing that the IOD sisters always say. Is that when you're stamping on fabric, you have to make it super juicy. When you're stamping on like furniture or anything slick, then you don't want it to be as juicy. All oh, right. Super chat from Paula, thank you.
That thing's super loaded up now. We'll see, we might get like a fun faded kind of effect going.
Let's see, oh, Debbie's on here. Hey, Deb. All right, let's see. How does it work?
I'll bring you guys in closer in just a minute.
Oh yeah, juicy better. So just make it juicy. The other thing that you can do too is when it's all dry, you can absolutely sand it and give it a distressed look. I've done that a ton when I've stamped and stenciled drop cloth. And you know, I like to distress everything because it hides my mistakes. All right, can you guys see that this one is darker than this one?
I don't know that they can see anything
all right,
at all.
Maybe we need to move the camera around that side of the table so that way they can. I touch the camera, but I know that you don't like it when I do.
Things go weird.
I'm nothing if not an obedient wife.
Stop it.
Hey, Jamie,
like
what should I price
those
sap buckets at? I think I sent you a video, Debbie, but I would say like $29.95 for those sap buckets.
Did you not send the video? Did it not go through? Did
I don't
you
know.
Ever check
I emailed
to see
it to her, but I don't think she got it because she didn't use it in her video.
Oh, email is never, you should have texted it. It was like a 20-second video.
Oh. They can see the difference.
All right.
Yeah, we actually should be unboxing some military buckets that we picked up when we were at market. They're actual vintage. We got to get them out of the box today. They shipped to us last week.
They're ammo canisters.
They're ammo canisters. That's what it is. Zeb's all excited about them. I'm not so sure like what our following will like ammo canisters or not.
I think that they've got a lot of fun uses for like decor and flowers and things.
Who has used the Pavo stamp before? Because I have not. Oh, right. Debbie didn't see the video. Well, I emailed it.
Yeah, we hustled up and got it done.
You should sand these first, but do you want to go? Hand me that sandpaper right there. It's under the scissors. So we're just barely opening.
Heavy.
It's fine. I'm just going to go soft. We're just barely opening these stamps, and when you get them, you're just going to use fine sandpaper to scuff them up a little bit. And what that does is it gives that stamp a little bit of tooth, so that way whatever you're putting on it is going to adhere a little bit better.
Here, they can't see what you're talking about.
They can see what I was doing. I was in the corner of the video. You can keep going. I'm just sanding the stamp.
Okay, so I'm going to show you stamping as we go. And I'm not going to do border on the side. We're just going to do top and bottom.
Are you going to do the same border on the top?
I might do these down the side. That could be cool.
Yeah, that'd be fun. This is kind of a bohemian-inspired piece, which is totally out of our wheelhouse. But I feel like every now and then, Zeb says we got to do things a little different.
Wheelhouse.
Wheelhouse. It's all the same. Carolyn says, my husband had an ammo canister. He kept little tools in and kept it in the truck. So the ammo canisters we got are actually perfect for storing fake flowers.
They're really not tall. Square. They're like tall and metal and round.
Yeah. Oh, Ivy's on here. She just dropped the Wander transfer link. Oh, sounds like Jean is here for the day. Linda says, I love boho. Oh, good. Good, good, good. Oh, you're living dangerously.
I've been doing it on top the whole time.
If I did that, I would get ink all over the drop. Nicole says, going to use sweet lions on or without.
Probably sweet
Bondi? Bondi. I'm looking for extra chippy. If it's too chippy.
It sounds like she's got some typos. Sweet pickens.
She must be using voice text. So
with
going to use sweet pickens without extra bond. If it's too chippy, you can just sand it and then add some extra bond and put more paint on there. Absolutely. You should say the phrase a little bit out of the farmhouse. Caitlin and Ivy are on here. Caitlin, aren't you supposed to be picking up my nephews from school? Don't you forget those babies.
Maybe she's in the parking lot waiting.
I know. She's a good mama. Jana says she really loves the printable this month for channel members. Yeah, I love it too. Sheep and horses are my jam.
We got more cool ones like that coming. That's what I was working on last night. I was drawing up some flowers, and like my favorite medium to do like hand like art like that is Prismacolor colored pencils, which I just like the accuracy of it. I'm not good with a small little paintbrush. I don't love it.
Colored pencils are kind of your thing.
Yeah.
Debbie says that you're brave. She'd be messing that up. Debbie, you will also notice that I am just responding to comments. I cannot stamp live if it requires any kind of accuracy. Zeb's like super good at stamping.
All right, what's next?
Okay, so next we're going to be adding the next layer of this. So we've got, I'm pulling off my Pavo. Now, I've not layered these on before, so let's just figure out this are going to go.
I'm going to work from this way so they can see it.
Okay, I'm just going to put the design on there. Okay.
We got to build a bird.
I know, but they are mirror image birds, so there's two peacocks.
Okay.
So this is is this the top of our piece here? Is that how you're going to do it? Okay, so let's... Can we figure out where the center is on this?
I don't think it's that the ink is drying out. I think it's because this has been painted on and it's fabric and it's got a lot of highs and lows, so it's not getting on every little piece. And it's been painted on previously too.
Yeah.
Because the ink, I mean, it's got a ton of ink on this.
It says remember to mask with the Pavo. Well, guess what? We don't have any. So this is going to be interesting because you're supposed to like layer it on there. You guys want to know how to mask, go to the Iron Orchid Designs sisters website. Is it IOD or Iron Orchid Designs on YouTube?
They do Iron Orchid Designs on YouTube.
They have an amazing, amazing, Seb, don't start inking it yet.
Why?
Because I haven't laid it out. Like, seriously, wipe that off. I got to figure out what we're doing.
Well, I'm laying out my design. Just leave the bird like there. All right, I didn't realize you were laying
it out. I also said let's measure for the center.
Oh. Art's not centered.
Yeah, it is.
Never. You want, like, the best art is asymmetrical because it moves your eye across.
All right, well, still measure the center, please. So it doesn't give me an eye twitch. The board already looks distressed. One step safe. Yep.
Yep, it's already frayed. And some of that'll go away when we put the trim on there.
1041. All right, we might not get this one all the way finished because I really want to show you the transfer one. But here's
that. We'll give you an idea of what's going on.
I feel like you're kind of going rogue, so you do what you...
So 34, here, we'll just do this. There, that's pretty much center right there. So 17 is center. You were there. You were there on center.
Zeb, do it your way. Please, no eye twitching. And Carol says she knows the eye twitch. Guys, I'm trying to save you from eye twitching. That's why we busted out the measuring tape.
So how do these go on here?
So you're supposed to mask it.
I might do. Masking's easy. We'll just get a piece of paper and...
Well, I don't have a piece of paper.
I got the transfer thing right there.
All right. Well, there you go. If masking's easy, go for it.
I don't need this.
You don't need that?
Nope.
You're going to freestyle it?
Yep.
Okay. So these are like ones higher than the other. Does that matter?
I don't think so. And this one's also farther over than that one. And I'm okay with that.
Okay, but I really.
You want them to be centered? Well, I can fix it with this here.
Okay, you do that one and then we'll measure based off of how you stamp that one. That's how we'll stamp this one. How about that?
Okay.
I'm going to go to the basement and check our other drop cloth, see if it's dry.
All right, wish me luck. I'm doing this unsupervised, guys.
Unsupervised. If I yell, I'm going to get comments about it. I wasn't yelling.
I feel like you guys have a weird version of yelling and arguing. Like, I don't feel like we've ever really got into an argument on camera. Maybe some slight disagreements, but some people comment. They're like, oh, you're arguing. I can't watch. And I'm like, oh, that was an argument? I didn't know. Because we had a disagreement on a paint color or a position on a stamp. It always makes me chuckle a little. All right, got that way juicy. And the ink has a little bit longer open time than paint. So maybe I should have put this on the mount. I'm going to put it on the mount. Sorry, you guys are watching my hands work today.
I feel like that we should film behind the scenes when we're doing edited videos so people can hear when you're like, Jamie, just smile and let's do this. Zeb edits
out. I remind her to put her cheerleader smile on. Sometimes she gets super focused with painting.
Zeb edits out all the bossy pants. I feel like it comes from like, so Zeb's mom has 6 kids.
Oh.
And she could be yelling at them one moment. And then somebody calls and she's like, hello?
She's gonna watch this and die.
She knows. Zeb's kind of the same way. If we're live on camera, he's really good at keeping himself in check. But then when it's just the two of us, he's like, all right, let's go.
Oops.
Let's get to it. I'm the opposite. Pretty much on camera Jamie is the same as off camera Jamie.
All right. I lost. I had a little paint dab. I was remembering where the center was. I lost it.
Debbie said we were super nice to each other when she came out. That was probably a pretty stressful time for us. We try to be nice because the reality is at every point in our lives, there's always something going on that's crazy. And there's no way I would be able to work every day with somebody that drove me insane and vice versa.
Okay.
All right. Jen says it would be awesome to hear the real situation. Zeb is never gonna leave his real situation in a video. maybe I can like film him without him knowing. Zeb, can you turn fur logs that were cut 2 years ago? Yeah. That'd probably be better because they'd be nice and dry, huh?
Yeah, usually. I mean, the fur,
So I forget the formula, but it's like a month for every quarter of an inch on your thickness of your wood. That might be wrong. I'd have to look it up, but that's how long you need to let it dry out if you want it to cure.
So if you're just tuning in, Zeb's using the Pavo stamp, and then on the bottom we used Bohemia. Maybe a little juicier even.
Well, I feel like this whole thing is going to be like that, and it's kind of what I want. Like, it's got that distressed age kind of feel to it.
Right on. Plant a wire, Jamie. That's funny. I don't know. I don't know about planting a wire. All right. Let's see. Have you used any of the colored inks for stamping? Yeah, we used the green ink on a pillowcase. I kind of feel like if this paint was all the way dry, it probably would adhere a little better too.
Maybe.
Show 78 says she's loving the worn look. I would think so, because Show 78 is like my spirit animal.
She has the worn look perfected.
Yeah.
She's real good at that.
Her and I have the same opinion. Like, the older, the crustier, the better. Linda says, pop of turquoise. Now, what you could absolutely do when this is dry is go ahead and come back with some watered-down paint and almost use it like those paintable transfers. We've done that with black and white before, too. That would be fun. Debbie says, we all got through the France fiasco with no yelling, except Dion pulled out her mom voice, and my sister did let me have
it. I almost laughed when Dion got excited, because it was so unexpected.
I would add a little bit more. I feel like that was dry.
It's not dry.
Okay, we'll see. On the head. Okay.
Now I got over.
Yeah, Dion's mom voice is pretty not scary.
It was just unexpected. I was like, what just happened?
Karen says, open. I'm here for my paint fix. She must be outside. Hey, Jamie, love seeing you use that artsy creative design genius. Yeah, it's not me. I come up with the designs in my mind, and then I'm like, hey, Zeb, could you help a sister out with this? And he's committed.
I wasn't worried about it being even. I mean, when birds are standing next to each other, they're not gonna look like even.
I feel like this is gonna take lots of layering.
Yeah, we could really. How's that thing looking downstairs?
It's
still.
Right,
oh,
here,
you have it right there. Oh, look how cool that is.
I don't know how a transfer's gonna adhere to it, but we're gonna try. All right, so. So when you see these, they're normally like attached on the ones I've seen, but I kind of feel like you could also just use them like that, just like as a.
I feel like that makes the bird look weird.
I don't want to attach it like that. Do you want to? I guess we can, if that's what you want to do. Zeb is the stamp Yoda. Lately, we've been cheating on Star Wars and watching a lot of Star Trek. It's starting to affect my sleep.
Jamie hasn't really ever watched Star Trek. And she did not realize how much different than Star Wars it is. They get real scientific and sciency in Star Trek, whereas in Star Wars it just works. And
we're watching Discovery, the new one on CBS.
Yeah.
So you need to like cut off that portion, cover it.
I'm not gonna cut it. Yeah, I'll yes.
Kind of put this there.
I'm not gonna cut it off. I'm just gonna mask it right there on the edge. But there will be no
What
cutting.
Is that? I feel like the people that complain about the little combos y'all have might not be married. You know what it is, like, and I hope this does not offend anybody, but I'm going to get real here. A lot of people do not like it when a woman talks back to her husband because they're kind of old school.
Oh, here, we'll go up top.
And they get a little bit more. It's funny because some of the things I do, Zeb does too, but because I'm like a strong, opinionated woman, they don't really like that. And so it's really offensive. And Zeb is super sweet, especially on camera. So they feel like I'm kind of pushy with
them. I'm super sweet always.
And so they're like super offended. How dare you get saucy with your husband? But that's like, I've been saucy for 20 years. That's why I think initially
changed.
Attracted him to, or me to him.
Oh man, I love Jamie's strong personality. It's it's why I married her. I'm like, yeah, going places.
And if you ask the kid which one of us is a softer touch.
I tried to be a stay-at-home dad for 2 years.
I was his sugar mama.
I need something clear to mask this with so I can see it. So we've got the other mounting, flexible mount here. What do you think about that?
Maybe move this over just a scotch. Like, I don't care if it, there we go.
You don't care if it goes
Well, I don't care if it layers a little bit because right up there, there you go.
Okay. Right there, good, yeah. Going over to the side like this?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Okay.
Oh, but I think
shut
that,
the door.
I think that Gene has let people in the store. It's getting loud out there.
It's all right.
Kimberly says, I can totally relate to that dynamic. All right, now let's see. Oh, that totally worked.
Boom.
Ta-da! I call that masking for lazy people like us that don't want to actually cut out the parts.
All right. Okay, I'm going to do
Cindy
this other
says,
bird.
Cindy says, it's true, Jamie. It's a double standard. It totally is. And we're used to it, and it's totally fine because at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter what other people think about our relationship. It matters about what we think.
Okay. So...
it's funny because Zeb is actually pretty passive most of the time, but when he has an opinion on something, I just kind of like, there's no point in arguing with him. Like, there, you will not change his opinion, so you should probably just go with it.
I try to not have very many opinions.
Tara says she needs a goat stamp transfer or stencil. I never even thought about a goat, so that might have to wait till my summer release. I've actually submitted all of my stencil designs for the new 2020, and it's a big release, so it's taking a while for my graphic designer to get through everything.
So we're a little off somehow, but like we're like half an inch.
You know what you could do is just pull the tail a little bit out.
It would be really long.
That's fine. It might like trick the eye.
Okay.
Do you want to put this there?
Yeah, where's the little screen? Oh, I couldn't even see that there.
See, you can see how well, look how well that ink did on that shiny surface.
On the plastic.
On the plastic, because it's not textured. So that's kind of what you can expect if you're stamping on something that's less porous than this drop cloth. Because drop cloth is made to absorb stuff.
Okay. Oops, that didn't go how I wanted. Don't drop your stamp on your mountain
Zoe
pack.
Says, I would love to see IOD come out with koi stencils. I feel like they had them maybe back in their Prima days, but I don't remember. There's some people, they know like every IOD product that's ever came out.
All right, so I got a little over with my block. So I'm
Joanne, how's it going with my Invisalign? I haven't been wearing them for the last 2 days, but it's going good.
My Invisalign's going great.
Yep. I'm probably going to be done in the next 3 or 4 months.
It was hard wearing them for like the first month, but I got used to it and it's not been a big deal.
They said that's too high on its booty. Well, it's done now. We've committed. Maybe this peacock's been working out and its booty's gotten raised a little
or
bit.
Or it's mad and it's down.
All right, so
I feel
we
like
have,
that worked.
Yeah, I feel like it did too.
You know what? I'm gonna go even more rogue.
Well, we actually have some other areas of the...
Hold on. I want that to be thicker up right there, like right here, like the other one. Oops.
Did you want to put some extra pieces on there?
So I think I'm gonna...
Shannon was laughing at my workout booty. It's true, when I work out, my butt gets higher. I feel like we're gonna probably have to. What are you doing?
I'm using another stamp to mask.
I'm super confused as to
I want it to be thicker like this one is up at the base of the bird, so I'm just gonna add some over the top.
Oh, be careful. I'm gonna look away.
It'll be all right.
Decor B, we are making some tapestries. All right, I say let's skip to the next technique and we will get this finished. Oh gosh. Now you need to restamp the whole thing.
I'll distress it when it's done. Actually, I might distress it right now.
No, it's gonna smear and ink has longer opening time. Debulin, you're giving me heart failure over here.
See, we're not arguing, we're just disagreeing.
Yeah, because I'm right. Yeah, ink has a lot longer open time than paint. So if you were doing this with paint, you'd have to stamp really fast. It would probably show up a little better, but then it might dry out quicker. Whereas ink doesn't show up as much as paint, but you get more detail and you have more open time. All right.
Jamie's right, I should have left that alone.
Laura says blot, no rubbing. It's okay. We are going to set this aside and I'm gonna come back. We're gonna add a lot more detail because I just feel like it needs more.
We will show you a community. If you don't know what community is, if you go to the homepage of our YouTube channel, that's where you can find all the finished and some of the behind the scenes. And if you're a channel member, that's where you get all of your printables and stuff.
Okay, so I don't want to put those wood parts on this until I'm finished because I'm gonna have to put it back down. We're gonna get to the next one, which is actually my original idea. The stamping was secondary.
Here, I think I'm gonna also
tack
this one.
Yeah, if you wanna set that over
there. I'm gonna
hold
this
up
so they can see.
So we're gonna add some more to it, then we'll distress it, and I think it's gonna be cool.
Yeah, it's not quite dry yet, like the paint's still there.
Okay, so this is our drop cloth. This one is definitely, oh gosh.
Did you get some sawdust on it?
I think you did when you had it in the basement. Okay. This one, how you can see circles, it's got all kinds of distress situation happening here, but we did seal this one with liquid patina. If you wanted a less distressed look on your drop cloth, then just use a brand new drop cloth. We totally used an old one, which I'm fine with because we're gonna put the design down on the bottom, may even do some white wax. So let's tack the top zip and then we'll stretch the bottom and we'll put the transfer on.
Okay.
So this is the one that we're gonna be using the transfer on, and I'm really unsure because I've never put a transfer on painted fabric in my life. They said it looks like denim. And it actually does look like denim in real life.
It does, it's cool. But you can see there's a lot of texture and things from the old paint.
Please post on your Facebook page. I will. It depends on how they turned out. Sometimes things don't make it because I'm like, I need to work on that. I'm looking super skinny today. Sweet. I'm the same skinny as I was last week. Sally says she's nervous. Green-eyed lady says experimenting is good. Kelly says she loves this idea. And Peggy says she loves the bickering of you two. It shows love and respect. It would be gorgeous to just add a light.
I feel like bickering is too strong too. Like, we just have disagreements.
Strong disagreements. I almost think that it would be good if we ironed it, but we don't have an iron here.
Let me just run a heat gun over it real quick and see
if that'll
help soften it up and smooth it out a little bit.
Tony, we are using this as a backdrop for a transfer to create a tapestry, and then we're going to attach these to the top and the bottom to make a hanging piece of artwork. At least that's the idea. Is that helping kind of smooth it out a little? You don't really want it to be hot when you apply the transfer.
Oh, it won't. I don't think it's going to have enough of that heat.
Okay.
And the transfer is going to make it busy enough, I think, and cover up some of this stuff on here, too.
Okay, so Ellen J. Goods puts the transfers on fabric somehow, and it's magical. I probably should have messaged Ellen, but I didn't think she wanted to talk to me at 10 o'clock last night. What are the two circles on the bottom?
It's probably
something that we painted. This was an actual used drop cloth, so it had paint on it already. And I feel like the dark shows kind of those imperfections coming through, which is fine.
All right,
so where's the
up.
Transfer?
Where'd we set it?
It's, oh, you put it way over there.
Did I put it in the corner?
Do you want me to go grab it? I just don't want to knock things over.
I got it.
Okay. Make steam to soften the fabric. Yeah, I think that would work too. Or just ironing it, put a piece of fabric over it and iron it. Good option.
Okay. All right, so I usually just open these with like a small little like knife or something, sharp edge. They just have a little piece of tape.
So this base color is Hey Sailor. I wanted something dark to really show off all the fun colors in the transfer. It says it looks like a bike. Touche. Carolyn says it's not even bickering. You guys are best friends and grew up together like me and my hubby. 52 years since her first date.
Oh, that's a good long while. Yeah. That's working.
So this has already been sealed with liquid patina before we put the transfer on and completely dried. So this is the transfer that's going on here. I don't know that I want to do this piece up here, though.
Okay, let's...
I think that would... Actually, you know what? It's okay.
I think it's fine, but I need to move it.
But my concern is make sure you leave enough gap on top and bottom.
I'm not going to worry about centering it because it's going to be kind of fluid anyway.
Yeah, no, it's fine. I just make sure we have space for this to come across here because you're going to tack it from behind, aren't you?
Yeah, and some of it might get covered up on the bottom.
You could also staple this on.
All right, you want to remove the... We're going to commit right now.
Oh, that has... I didn't know they had tape on them.
Yeah, they put tape on
that
them.
That must be a new thing. So this back is not attached, it's loose. So when you open your transfer, be careful. And once you put it down, you have to commit.
Okay, it's on there real light. Here, so, yeah, grab that corner and we'll...
Okay, having a partner, I think, it helps pull it that way a little.
It needs to go up just a hair, like more.
Up. Okay, but this is rolling over the set, so you need to pull yours that way. Okay, that's good. Well, we're going to commit. Good luck getting that down.
Well, yeah, this might be the hardest surface I've ever tried to do a transfer on.
This might be a total fail.
We'll see in a minute here.
Every time we do this, I always ask myself, why do I not test stuff out?
We do the experimenting so that we can tell you guys how stuff will and won't work when you ask the hard questions.
So somebody asked me earlier, and I don't remember who it was.
Watch out.
On our Saturday Night Live, we mixed two paint colors to create a really pretty French-inspired blue. It was Bohemian Blue mixed with Skeleton Key at a 50-50 mix, and that made a really great color.
I just wanted to see if I could get the transfer to break off, and it is breaking off.
Oh, okay. You want to grab me one so I can help you?
Yep. This has got a lot of detail, so it might take us a minute to do this.
This is breaking off. I could have picked an easier transfer, maybe.
Nah, this is going to look cool. So I think part of it is what is helping is the sealer is not 100% cured up. Like when you touch it, if you were to leave your hand on it, it might stick a little. I would not suggest it.
I feel like it's better if the sealer is all the way dry. We're just lucky that it's working for us.
You think?
I feel like, remember when I did the front door and my sealer was not all the way dry?
That's true.
That was a nightmare. Like you really want that sealer to be dry. I think in this case, it's okay because the fabric.
We're getting away with it.
Yeah, it's working. Like, I said a little prayer, like, please make this work so I don't look like a dork on YouTube. Just kidding. I'm not sure that God is concerned with my dorkiness. All right, I'm going to show you guys kind of how it's coming across so far.
It is actually transferring really easy.
Yeah, it is.
I've had furniture that's a little dusty transfer worse.
Yeah, you want to make sure if it's furniture, you've removed all the dust. Once you get the edge of the transfer on, you can kind of just pull it up, which is what I'm doing. You don't have to... It's what the sisters call riding the wave. The problem is there's so many dang different pieces on here. All right. So you guys will have to tell me what you think of this after we're done, and then go ahead and go to Anthropology and search tapestry so you can kind of get an idea where this idea originally came from. They do have some really fun ones on there. Now, if you have a piece, like I just had a piece there that didn't adhere, I just set it back down and got it to go. Because sometimes you don't push hard enough and it doesn't come off.
You think you'd seal this up with like Big Top?
Yeah, you can seal with Big Top or just put more liquid patina on it.
Yeah.
Probably we'll go ahead and attach it to the top and the bottom and we can put that sealer on later. Looking like a dork is keeping it real. Well, that's good because I have always been a little bit awkward my entire life. I don't know what I can attribute that to, but I am. Are you coming over there, Zeb?
I'm doing pretty good. All these little leaves might be winning.
Here, I'm gonna bring this so you guys can get the top down view for a minute.
So G Davis says $50 to $178. So this transfer is about 30 bucks.
The drop cloth's pretty much like a dollar worth of drop cloth here.
Yeah. And some of the styles they have are cool, but they're not like my style necessarily, so.
I really like the stamping idea. You could, sky's the limit with the stamping. The Eye of These Sisters has so many really fun detailed stamps and the paintable ones too. So you could just really go to town and get a lot of really fun designs going that are really unique and different.
Well, you could even make smaller ones to do like farm, if you want to do like farm animals and frame them out, that would be fun.
We're gonna have to really burnish this.
You can only use the transfer, yes, one time, because it's essentially like a really, really thin vinyl sticker. So it's not like a stencil or a stamp that you can use over and over again. But look at the color on that. Like, I don't know that I could paint a stamp to look that cool. Yeah, it's a rub-on. And if you were not doing it on fabric, it's a little bit faster. This takes a little bit longer.
Are you watching comments?
Yeah, I am. Artists are usually awkward. That's a great thing. That's true. And I'm not super organized. I was actually talking to Sasha from Sweet Pickens. What were we talking about? Oh, we're talking about stencils. And she said that Santi, her husband, misplaced her stencils. And she's like, someday I'm going to be organized. And I'm like, probably not. And she's like, you're probably right. Because I'm the same way. Oh, did you want, I'll finish this top part so we can rip this off. You can almost kind of hear it like
a little pop.
Pop
sound.
When you're, this little detail is hard. Yeah, I'm gonna come back to that. I feel like this is coming off easier. That might have been a little more wet there.
Yeah, maybe. It was on the top of my box.
The nice thing about these transfers too is that the edge, so there's a lot of different transfer brands out there, right? And the way you know a quality transfer is that the image should not be pixelated at all. And the edge, we call it the halo, should be really close to the design, because if you have a thick halo, it makes it look fake, like a sticker. So the smaller the halo, the better looking your transfer is going to be. So when you're purchasing transfers, don't buy the kind that have a really thick edge around it, because then you're gonna have to try to cover that up, and that's a pain in the bum.
Hopefully this isn't too boring watching us put this transfer on here. It's gonna take a minute.
What do you think this will sell for? I'm hoping that it'll sell for somewhere between, like, I don't know, like $70 to make it worth my time. It's not super big. I feel like if you did like a super pristine job, you could probably even get more. Being that this is my first try, so it's not exactly perfect, I don't know that I'll be able to ask as much for it. You know what always happens is we come up with these ideas live, and then people do it, like, see us, and then they do a better job.
All right, so the steps for the drop cloth. So on this particular one with the transfer, we took the DIY paint, and the drop cloth had old crusty paint on it already, and we just kind of gave it a uniform color all the way across. This is Hey Sailor that we used on here. And then after that, before the paint was even dry, I just went back over with the liquid patina. And then we dried it out, and now we're putting the transfer on.
And people are gonna ask, why did you use patina as opposed to Big Top? We used it because it's thicker. And I wanted something to give some thickness to this fabric. Something for that transfer to give it some weight. Gonna be here a hot minute.
I'm hurrying.
Like I might even work a little sweat. I won't need to work out today. I'm getting my cardio in.
Terry says it has to be so hard to make such beautiful things and then have to sell them because you can't keep everything. I like money too.
If we really, really like it, we usually make another one.
Yeah, or like the things I know that I can't recreate, I'll keep. I like what I do because I can create so many different things and I never have to worry about having too much stuff because I get to enjoy it for a while at the shop and then I sell it and it moves on. What about golden ticket? Yeah, you could totally put some golden ticket on this and that would be pretty if you wanted to add some metallic.
Here, look a little peek over here on my corner. Oh, that's not down.
You're showing a corner that's not down, Zip? I don't know why I always pick these really big projects to do live.
Let's see, we've been live for 65 minutes and I still got to get the wood on here.
That's all right, we'll get it done.
We've been going with these long live projects lately.
Sometimes it takes a little bit longer, you know? And I always like to, no matter what, I want to finish it as much as possible because I hate when I watch live videos and then you got to catch another live later to see what happens.
Yeah, it doesn't.
As long as you get most of the idea. Sometimes you can't stay, but all right.
Yeah, sometimes we gotta go run kids or something, but not today.
They are all in school. This is like the little tiny detail they're killing me.
These little peas up here are the ones that are hardest. Oh, you didn't get yours finished.
No, this was like giving me fits, so I moved on. I was like, nope, I'll come back to that later. All right, we're almost there, guys. I'm gonna let you finish that, and then I'm going to take a paper towel and burnish it. In this application, burnishing is going to be really important because you want to make sure all those edges are down and being kind of an uneven surface.
Oops, sorry with the crazy camera, guys.
Being kind of an uneven surface, you do want to make sure that it adheres well to all the details. It says, would you help if you hit the top of it with a heat gun?
No, you don't want. I don't know that you want to melt the transfer.
I don't know that I want to try that when I've never done it before.
I've never put the heat gun to the transfer. It's so thin, I worry that it would just melt the adhesive and the plastic all together.
And it's pretty, oops, I'm taking off pieces of the transfer.
It hasn't been that bad. It's just this transfer. Oh, too much burnishing.
Too much burnishing. That's all right. It's a little distressed up there.
Maybe we just need to like pat it down and make sure it's on and then
burnish it.
No, I would seal it and then do it.
Oopsie daisy. Yeah,
it's just distressed.
Yeah, that's what it is. All right, I'm just going to go back to applying my transfer.
Yeah, work on that top. We need that top part finished. I got my side done.
Got your side done. Good job. I don't know why, but this top is like a lot harder than the bottom. Alright. Just lay the backing over it and burnish it. Oh, that's smart. Good job, Laura. That's why we have you guys. I'm going to do what Laura says because I feel like that would work better. How are you doing over there?
We're like two-thirds of the way done.
Okay, I'm going to come from this angle. Oh, why is it so much easier coming from this angle and pulling up?
I don't know why,
but going the opposite direction, it was just spiting me. I don't know, but this is sure working better. Okay, careful. It's fine. Sometimes what you can do too is cut off the second. Well, I guess we don't want to cut it off because we want to use the sheet to burnish it with. But a lot of times I'll cut off the section that I'm done with so that way it's not sticking back down on it.
Audi's sisters are gonna see this and be like, what off-label use are they doing today?
Yeah, this is definitely considered off-label, meaning if it doesn't work, you didn't hear it from us. Kind of like when we do it on mirrors. I'm on. That was so much faster from this opposite direction. Good you. Done. All right.
Here, work like down that corner there.
You do have to kind of pull it up when you do it, huh? Because I feel like
it helps.
Just,
yeah.
To release it. It's looking good so far. The colors are really splashing on the fabric. Tony must have said something funny. Is that my dining room table? No. No, that would be funny if my dining room table had this much paint on it. This is our studio in the back of our retail store. So we have a website, which is jamierayvintage.com, but then we also have a retail store in Lehigh, and that's where we sell the projects that we do. And we also sell all the supplies here. All right, that's done. This, I think we messed up from pulling it up. It's probably better if one person at a time.
Oh, it's not sticking?
Well, it kind of stuck to itself. It's all right. Looks good. All these little details now.
You picked it.
I know. I feel like the easiest transfer in the world is the Flora transfer.
This is how like huge big flowers.
Yeah, instead of all these little ones. People are probably like talking. I'm not even paying attention. Are you gonna seal it?
Yeah. We're gonna go back right over it right now.
We'll
I'll put
it.
The wood on first so you guys can see what the wood looks like. And then we'll seal it off.
Could you use
camera.
A bigger tool? Maybe.
I tried running it sideways and it wasn't working. It
requires a good amount of pressure to get it adhered. If the patina underneath was all the way dry, it would be a lot easier, but we did not have time for it to dry all the way. All right, I'm gonna come back this way and do this part. What I like about the Wander transfer is it has like these solid pieces, and then in the background it's got like these pieces that you just have the outline, which is kind of fun.
They want to see. They want to see what it looks like, if it's actually possible to
do
this.
That's
good. They want to see if we ruined a $30 transfer or if it works. I think it's working.
Like I'm gonna earn myself a cheeseburger or something.
Yeah, something.
Get my cardio in. Okay. Oh, I gotta finish this flower here. I mean, you know, it's funny, we talked about it taking a long time, but it's just long because we're live, because we've only been doing this for like 10 or 15
minutes.
How long would it take you to paint something like this?
Oh, hours,
more than 10 or 15
hours,
minutes.
Hours.
Okay, is this not attached? Can you guys see that?
Oops. Yeah, we're pushing pretty hard with the edge of these sticks.
Okay, I'm gonna let you finish that portion.
Okay.
I'm just gonna make sure it's like pushed down. I'm just gonna burnish it with my hand. Cause I'm worried if we burnish it with this, it'll kind of stick back to the release paper.
We're almost there. I'm like working on the last flower here.
Shelly says this is looking amazing. Jacorby says she can't wait to see. It's looking great. I really love the dark background on here. I'm not a, like, I don't use hay sealer a lot, but I wanted these pinks to really pop against it. The unretired designer says, I'm so glad you're trying to transfer. I'm not sure I would try it if I hadn't seen you do it. It looks awesome.
Just lost a leaf right here.
The nice thing about what we're doing is this is a piece of art, meaning this is going to go on a wall. Somebody's not going to scrub it. Nobody's sitting on it. So it's much less worrisome than if you put this like on a seat. I feel like that would be a little bit more difficult.
Okay, now I'm going to put the trim on it, so to speak. Sorry, lots of crazy camera today. Ooh, 75 minutes. This is a long line.
Sorry, guys.
We did two projects
and we
in
even
one.
Prepped the backdrop. So if you guys are just tuning in, this is Hay Sailor over the top of an old crusty drop cloth that already had paint on it. Then we sealed it with liquid patina. We let it dry, which we didn't let it dry long enough, which is why it was a little bit difficult to get the transfer on there. And then we added the Wander transfer to it. Now, if I had to do this over again, I would do a few things. One, I would make sure the liquid patina was all the way dry. Two, I would take an iron, before I put the transfer on, I'd put another piece of fabric over the top and iron it down nice and smooth. That way the transfer would go on easier. So those are some of the things I learned from this.
I don't think it's gonna stick. I'm just gonna...
Well, this is the shiny side. It won't stick to that.
Yeah.
All right, so we're using Laura's idea, I think that was her, and we're burnishing using this over the top just to make sure all the pieces are adhered. Even if you are doing this on a piece of furniture, you always need to burnish it to make sure that there's maximum adherence. And we are trying to replicate a tapestry design that I saw on Anthropology. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead, we will seal this.
I'm gonna flip it over. All right, there's kind of a look there. We will seal it. I don't know if we're going to get to that right now.
No, but we're going to just show you the top. So, what are you doing?
So
are you going to do it from there, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so now we're adding the pieces of wood to the top and the bottom. It will also add some weight, give us something to hang it on the wall, and the piece of wood on the bottom will just let it hang better on the wall. At least that's the theory.
So my thumbtacks have a half inch thing, and this is only 3/8 of an inch thick, so.
Is it gonna go all the way through?
Here, let me, I can't see what I'm doing.
House to Home says, you can barely see the bicycle wheels. Yeah, the transfer covered up that weird circles that were on there because we had paint. So we are using tacks. However, that being said.
You could use staples or.
You could totally use staples. Zeb, would you just tack it just on each side and then we'll tack it in the middle later?
I'm gonna do one in the middle so
okay.
It doesn't. So I'm just cutting these tacks because my board is only 3/8 of an inch thick.
Oh, you're making them shorter?
Yeah.
All right, so if it were me, I would probably just use a staple gun, but these tacks are what we had on hand.
Well, the staples would be too long too. They're half inch
yeah.
as well.
So if you want to order this transfer, you go to jamierayvintage.com. This is the Wander transfer, and it's in the IOD menu of our website. There's a bunch of other designs there as well, and every transfer, the size is listed in the description, so you can kind of gauge whether or not that will work for your project. And you can use them on fabric, but what they're made for is to go on wood. So if you like this color combination, you could totally paint a dresser in Hay Sailor and put this Wander transfer on the dresser as opposed to like a fabric piece like this. We just wanted to see if we could do it.
Hopefully it's not all sticking to the table since I just barely put this over there.
So Jasmine says, I'm so in love with this. I've been waiting to find a way to do tapestry and exactly what you're doing. I'm so happy to see you try it out before she went to try it. Well, I'm glad that we could be the guinea pig situation here. I feel like you could also take, this would be a good way if you had a bunch of leftover portions of transfers, you could create a unique design combining them all, kind of the way Debbie did that video. Was it a bee that she made out of transfer leftovers? I think it was. So you could take them and make them into something different.
All right, almost there. Then we'll show you the other one that we stamped. If you're just joining, we did some stamping at the beginning of the video.
Z is a perfectionist. He is. He's also having to cut each individual tack because they're too long.
I don't want them to poke through. That's all right, they cut.
Jen says we're off-label rock stars. And Susan wants to know the difference between white swan, beadboard, and vintage linen. So if you are not familiar with DIY, those are three different white colors. White swan, now this is all my personal opinion. I feel like everybody sees color differently. To me, white swan is a warm white. Beadboard pulls blue, and vintage linen is gray-white. Some people tell me that they feel like beadboard is the gray-white and vintage linen is the blue-white, but in my opinion, beadboard pulls blue and vintage linen pulls gray.
All right, here's time for the reveal. We'll see how it did.
That's the bottom.
Yep. I'm gonna put more tacks on this too.
Yeah, we'll do more tacks.
So that it doesn't hang weird.
How cool is that? So I think.
And we'll probably use like a burlap, like twine or something, or not burlap, a hemp twine to hang it with.
Yeah, this is awesome. I think it's gonna really add some spring to the store, show people kind of the versatility of transfers, and there you go. So this was my original plan, the stamping. Hopefully people watch past the stamping. And get to this part because I think this is really cool.
And the frayed edge is kind of fun, and it. Oh, my tack came out on this.
Laura says, "Holy moly, I have to do one."
So, just keep working with it. Make sure your stuff's dry. I mean, we do kind of things a little quicker on the live videos, so you know, give it time, and it'll turn out good.
All right, guys. I hope this inspires you to create DIY things on your own without always having to worry about buying retail, because I feel like you get a little bit of your own personal style, and we're going to show you the stamped one again if you're just tuning in.
So this is the one with the stamp. Yeah. I'll give you the close-up. You can actually see quite a bit of the detail now that it's all drying out.
Teganique, I would call them and say, hey, I want to know what if your tarnished pearl is old or new. And the retailer should be able to tell you that. A lot of retailers don't have the new tarnished pearl because they haven't reordered yet. We have some of the old, but most of everything we have is new. We have it labeled on our cans.
Okay, so we will seal over this. We're gonna let everything kind of just sit and settle down for a little bit, and then we're gonna seal over it. Yeah.
Well, I guess we can leave them on because we need to seal these too, yeah?
Yeah, I wasn't gonna worry about sealing these, but all right, guys. We're way over time. Thanks for hanging out with us and staying with us today.
Give us a thumbs up and subscribe to January Vintage for more
DIY.
Love you guys. Oh, my head.